Well, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Ruth Baker's The Mind Matters program. I'm Linwood Jackson, of course. I don't look nothing like Ruth Baker. She's a little bit cuter than I am, but we will be hosting the show today. And I want to, Ruth Baker, she's taking a much needed break, but she will be back next time she's on air, or she's supposed to be on her, whatever her air time is. And but I will be hosting the show today, and I do want to thank her for allowing me this opportunity to share, you know, some of our guests with your audience today. And as you know, on my shows, you know, we're committed to giving good information and inspirational content every time we are on the air, and that's what we're going to bring today. We like to talk about the issues a little bit because we all know what they are. We like to talk about the solutions a little bit more because we don't know what they are. And y'all know we love to have fun because life is a balance, and that's what we want to share. And today my guests are going to be sharing a lot of that with you today. We have first up Miss Desiree Scott-McCray. She is with the Boy Scouts of America Outreach director there, and she's doing great things with our young boys, and she's going to talk to us a little bit about how you can get involved with the Boy Scouts of America. Next up, we have Mr. Mark Antony Williams. He is my favorite celebrity chef of all time. Of course, we all know he's working over at Celebrations on Market Street. Fine establishment. They're doing more than just cooking and eating over there. They're having a good time. We got Mr. Mark Antony Williams on to share with us what they got going on over there. And there's a lot going on. So break out your pencils and paper right now, because you're going to want to take these notes. That we're going to put out a lot of information, and I don't want you to miss any of it. And third up is a young lady I met the other day, and she was like, you know, it inspired me so much. I had to get her on. She is Serena J. Walker, a spoken word and motivational speaker. All right. Yep, that's right. She's a young lady, but she's motivating young people and old alike. So, again, get your pencils ready, because you're going to want to get this information that we are sharing today. Right off the bat, we're going to go straight to the Boy Scouts of America, Ms. Desiree Scott. How you doing today?
I am well, thank you.
You know, I met you not long ago as well, and you're inspiring. You know, again, we got to get you in here. We had to get you on and to talk to us a little bit about what you guys are doing with the Boy Scouts of America.
Exactly. Well, we're working hard. We're working extremely hard, and our goal is to prepare our youth to make ethical and moral decisions that'll prepare them for a lifetime. And so I specifically work within our outreach division of the Boy Scouts of America. So we are actually within the Wilmington area, in addition to Newcastle, Newark, and Bear. And so we charter with charter organizations. So we're currently in 14 schools and 5 community centers. We meet once a week for 1 hour a week, and then we also have monthly field trips. A couple of weeks ago, we took the boys down to Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, to the Franklin Institute.
Wow, really, that's pretty cool. You're getting them in that history.
Exactly.
Showing them some history at the Philadelphia. And you said you meet once a week.
We do.
Who's we?
And when
who's
I say
we, the Boy Scouts?
Exactly. Mm-hmm. So when boys between the grades of first and fifth grade meet, they are actually Cub Scouts. So we have weekly pack meetings for our Cub Scouts. And then our boys who are between the sixth and eighth grades, they're involved and engaged in troop meetings. And we, again, meet once a week for 1 hour per week. We currently have 2 troops within the Wilmington area, and that is at Bayard Middle School, and secondly, Stop the Violence Prayer Chain Foundation Incorporated. So those are our 2 troop locations, and then the remainder are Cub Scout packs, mm-hmm. Cub Scouts. And so, again, we meet on a weekly basis.
Any particular day in a week?
It kind of varies. Mm-hmm. We in the particular schools that we're in, we meet Monday through Friday, of course. Mm-hmm. We have particular days assigned where we'll come in. In some of the school systems, our programming is incorporated throughout their educational day. So, for instance, at Shortledge, Warner, and Eisenberg, we meet during a recess and lunch periods. So we may commence Cub Scout meetings at 11 and conclude at 1:45 because we work with third, fourth, and fifth grade.
Wow, not bad. You know, I remember I was a Boy Scout back in the day, and you know, we had to meet after school.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we had to, and on the weekend too.
Yes.
You know, it didn't take time. So it's good that you're right there in the school with the kids.
Yes.
and work with them on their time, I suppose. That way after school they can get out and do what they want to do.
Exactly. But then we do have some meetings where we do meet after school.
Mm-hmm.
When they're not able to incorporate us into their day program.
Okay.
And so for most schools it still works out because they have busing where if the youth stay after school, then they have late busing where if they rely on school buses to get home, they can still get home.
Pretty cool. Do you have to be an American citizen to be a Boy Scout?
Do you have to be an American citizen to be a Boy Scout? Absolutely not. The Boy Scouts of America is international. And so we are in many different countries, and so you don't have to be exactly an American citizen to volunteer for the Boy Scouts or even to participate within our PACs.
That's interesting. Volunteers. So you get volunteers, adult volunteers, I suppose, to help out with these meetings and with the boys in general. Do you have training for your volunteers?
We do. We have ongoing training. In fact, prior to commencing as a volunteer or even as a paid staff, you're required to go through certain phases of training,
mm-hmm.
youth protection training and things of that sort. And also, I mean, we have volunteer staff and we also have paid staff.
Mm-hmm.
So the requirement for training is universal across the board.
I got you. And what kind of volunteers are you looking for? What kind of qualifications do you have to be a volunteer?
Well, first and foremost, you have to have a yearning and an interest in your heart to help nurture and cultivate strong qualities within our youth. We're looking for individuals who, of course, live their lives on a particular moral and ethical standing.
Mm-hmm.
We're looking for individuals who are within the communities and are able to share a story and help build our youth. That's absolutely integral. And someone that our youth are able to identify with. But someone who's responsible, who's honest, with mm-hmm. great character and integrity.
Just a decent person all around. And you'll take them in. You need all the volunteer help you can get, I'm sure.
We do.
How many volunteers do you have right now? Do you know?
I couldn't give
not
you.
Enough.
I could say that. Mm. Not enough.
Not enough.
And we're always constantly doing ongoing recruitment for volunteers.
Okay, now what about uniforms and things like that? The Boy Scouts need uniforms. What are the costs? How much money is involved to be a Boy Scout?
Scouting can get expensive.
Mm-hmm.
However, let me just iterate this.
Mm-hmm.
Again, I work within our outreach division, mm-hmm. and so what we do is we attempt to remove the barriers mm-hmm. which would inhibit any family from participating and being a part of the Boy Scouts.
So you guys help with the cost?
We pay entirely. The
you
Del Marva
whole,
counter.
The total cost.
Exactly.
So it doesn't cost anything for to be a Boy Scout?
Not for outreach.
Not for outreach.
Not
okay.
for
so,
outreach.
But they need to buy their uniforms.
Nope. We purchase uniforms.
Oh,
we
that's
purchase
part of the outreach.
Exactly.
Oh, okay,
exactly.
Okay.
So we pay for registration. We pay for dues. We pay for uniforms, badges, belt loops. One field trip per month.
Mm-hmm.
We also run free camping services during the summer months. We also have our boys come out to our campsite locations to have camping for 5 nights, 6 days.
Wow.
So
a lot of activities going on in there.
Exactly.
And you need the resources to run these activities. So you take donations as well?
We do.
Okay, so you can donate if you're listening. You can donate at the and become a volunteer at the Boy Scouts of America website at boyscoutsamerica.org and sign up and help out with the Boy Scouts of America. Our youth need all the help they can get as far as funding and volunteer services. So if you got the time and the loot, then throw it out there. Help out somebody, right?
Thank you. Absolutely.
All right. We're going to come back and talk to you a little bit more, but I see my man Chef Tony over here, and he didn't bring nothing neat this time, but he usually does. That's why we love having him on. But Chef Tony, what's going on, man?
I'm How here you at your bequest.
Yes, you are, and I appreciate you stopping in at the last minute, man. And you know, we've been trying to get you on, though, for a minute and a half. I'm always out at Celebrations on Market, and you're always doing good work out there, man. You got all these projects going on. I know your deck is happening, but it's getting kind of cold now.
Yeah, we did just complete renovations on the deck, and so it's there for the spring. Right now, what we're doing is we're opening up two more nights a week to the public. On Wednesday nights, we call it our Jazz Steak and Seafood Night. And for $15.99, you can come in and have your choice of the steak feature of the evening, and we'll feature either some type of Alaskan crab legs or lobster, and that's for $15.99. And there's always live music, something eclectic, jazz, folk, classical guitar, it could be any of those things. So we just want to expose the community to different forms of music, and as long as we can continue to do it with no cover charge or admission fee, we will. But we like to promote dinner. It's a nice place to gather socially after work. And then on Thursdays, we're starting something called Thursdays After Work, and that's marketed towards a younger professional crowd. It's just going to be fun. Going to be featuring music such as Bhangra, Raga Rock, which is Indian music, and then of course, you know, it's standard American pop. But it would be a place where young professionals can gather after work, meet, talk to each other in a safe, clean environment. And of course, Fridays are always our old school parties. And then Saturdays is, we do a lot of private parties on Saturdays. And on Sundays right now, we're hosting the Pittsburgh Steelers fan club. So if you've never seen it, you have to come, because if there is a loyal group of people, it's the Pittsburgh Steelers. But it's a lot of fun. We have games, other games on our other TVs as well.
Pittsburgh, huh?
Pittsburgh.
That's interesting,
yes.
Tony. But, and you're right. I've been to a couple of them. They do show up. And I can't blame them right now, but it's interesting. We just had, when you say Pittsburgh Steelers, it reminds me of my favorite football player of all time, Mr. Antony Anderson, the first African-American Super Bowl champion, just happened to be from Pittsburgh, or played on Pittsburgh Steelers in 1980, I believe it was. You say Pittsburgh, that's the only reason why I like Pittsburgh. Or one main reason, they are a great team. And you're doing, you know, some great work out there, Chef Tony. You don't mind if we call you Chef Tony, do you?
No, we're trying hard. One thing I'd like to say is that we do give back to the community. We do a lot of fundraisers at the restaurant. This Thursday, I was blessed to be able to provide meals for single mothers and ladies. Friendship House, which is supported by Trinity Episcopal, which is a church I attend, was there. Hanifa Shabazz helped me bring in other families from the community. It was a very, very nice day. It was a nice Thursday.
Is this Thanksgiving?
Yes, we just did that. It's always nice to be able to give back. So, you know, I just cooked a wonderful meal, and we set the restaurant up family style, and whoever was in need could come and sit down and have a dinner.
Man, that's fantastic. You should have called me, bro. I was in deep, but it didn't sound, but we know we're doing good. Anyhow, that's great. You are reaching back to the community, and we commend you on that. We commend all of our guests that are doing the same thing, and that's why we brought you on to share all these great things that you are doing out at Celebrations on Market. And I believe you have a website, celebrationonmarket.com.
Yes, you can like us on Facebook. And on our Facebook page, you can sign up for our email so that you can receive information. And you can go to celebrationsonmarket.com. It just gives you more information about the facility. And of course, you're always welcome just to stop by.
All right, now we're going to come back. I want to talk to you about some of them great meals that you'd be preparing out there. I can't even name the names of them, but I know they're all good. You know what I mean? And I want you to share, if you don't mind, maybe one of your favorite recipes or one of your favorite meals you like cooking out of all of the great meals you like cooking. You can just share one with us. I'm going to come back. But do you have, like, spoken word at Celebration on Market any?
Yes, we have.
Open
and
mic.
We would do it again. Mm-hmm. The which is, that would fall into what our Wednesday category okay. of entertainment would be. Again, so spoken word to me is somewhat of an eclectic form of entertainment. It's not just your, what I call jump up and down music, and mm-hmm. it, that would fall into our Wednesday lineup there.
So. Well, that's good, because I have a young lady sitting right next to you, Miss Serena Walker, who is a spoken word and motivational speaker. Yeah. Serena, how you doing today?
I'm fine, thank you. I'm
good.
Happy to be here.
Good, good. Thanks, and we're glad to have you. And tell us a little bit about what you do. How would you describe your work as far as spoken word? What is that exactly, anyhow?
It's a form of poetry. It's kind of reminds people of rap sometimes. For me, it's a way of expression. It's an art form. I really love it, and it's a way I used it to express myself as well as express what I felt other people were feeling. Mm-hmm. And my poetry isn't just for me. I think it's for everybody. You know, if you can listen to it and you can gain something from it, that's great. And I want to incorporate that with motivational speaking, because whenever I wrote something, I believe I had something to speak on as well. So if I'm going to perform something, you can best believe, like, it means something to me.
Right.
Like, I wrote it for a reason, and that's all it is for, mostly for me, is like expression. And it's something, it speaks to people. You can get feelings from it. You know, sometimes when people talk to you, mm-hmm. it's just, they're talking to you and you don't feel nothing. You're just talking to them, mm-hmm. trying to listen, and you're not really listening.
You're talking that camera right there. There you go.
Well,
there,
right here. Yeah, I'm looking at you.
You're talking to them and you're expressing yourself so well. I don't want them to miss your expressions, because you're putting it out there.
No.
Now, did you went to college?
Yes.
And did you study communications in college?
Yes, I did. I majored in communications, and I had minors in Black American Studies and Women's Studies.
African American Studies.
Yes.
And Women's Studies.
Yes, those are my
wow.
minors.
Two good ones. And what can you share with us? What did you learn about African American studies when you were?
A lot. You know, like, I remember that was the first place where, college was the first place where I could really go in depth and study mm-hmm. my own background, you know? And I remember somebody telling me about, like, Marcus Garvey. And I was like, I didn't hear that name very much growing up. Why not? Mm-hmm. He did, like, amazing things. He was able to, this is before we had cell phones. This is before, you know, obviously, before cell phones, before.
Oh, you mean Marcus Garvey.
Yeah, Marcus Garvey. No, yeah. And he was able to reach all the way out to Africa, have a newspaper out to them every, you know, what I think it was a month or something.
That's
he was
right.
able to reach people overseas, back home. He's from Jamaica and different things. So that was interesting to me. Like, why haven't I heard about this man who was able to do so much mm-hmm. and reach so many people? Mm-hmm. And I remember I had one professor. I loved his class on Pan-Africanism. Mm-hmm. I loved it. I was at the end. I was like, thank you.
So what school did you go to?
High school, I went to Brandywine.
College,
I went to University of Delaware.
Okay, great. University of Delaware, a historical Black college and university.
No, that's Del State.
Del State. Okay, Del State. All right, I'm getting it twisted here. And so Marcus Garvey, I suppose he inspired you a little bit, motivated you to get into, you know, he's a great orator, and you just spoke very well about him. So I'm thinking, did he inspire you or influence you to get into speaking?
What got me inspired was maybe my mom. I don't know.
Okay, your
it
mother,
was like,
she's sitting right over there, by the
I
way.
Know.
Give a shout out. She did a fine
yeah,
job.
Shout out my mom, Daphne Walker.
Mm-hmm.
She gave birth to me.
mm-hmm.
I grew up writing. I don't know. Like, she would tell me, just, oh, you would write next to me while she did her homework, because she was in school at the time. And then I have a tape recorder of me just singing songs all
mm-hmm.
the time. Just, I don't know why, but it's just, I was always singing. Like, little kids like to do that, but I literally was just always making up songs.
Mm-hmm.
And I found out that I liked being on stage, even though I was a really shy mm-hmm. child. Like, you could come see me and I'd be like this. Mm-mm. You know,
extrovert.
But as soon as I got a mic or something, apparently I came alive. Like, people can tell
extrovert.
Me this, and I don't really remember it all. But yeah, so I, you know, it's a thin line for me. Like, it's like,
so you do a lot of writing.
I actually took a break, and now I'm definitely jumping back into it, because I'm pursuing this dream and everything. So I'm still in the beginning stages, but I'm definitely blessed for what's happening and what's going to occur, because I can feel it in you know, the poem I'm going to do today, it may sound like it's not giving you much hope, but when I speak on it, you know, that's where I want to tell people, like, there is hope and there is a chance, because the poem I'm going to do is called Life's Imprisonment.
Okay.
And it's just a feeling, because I want to speak to youth, and I've worked with youth, and I've talked to kids who look at me and say they can't do it. Like, just look at me, like, nah.
And you'd be like, nah, you can do anything, like, you want to do.
Yeah, but it takes more than just me saying it, and it takes more than just, like, having a dream. You got to follow your purpose. You got to know what people say, you know, what God has for you, he has for you, but you got to be willing to take it.
Right.
You can't just, oh, God has it for you. It's going to sit right there until you take it. So, you know, that's another concept. It's just like, oh, I have this dream. Well, you, like, I have to, right now, for me, I have to step on it. I have to take it. This is my purpose, and I have to take what God has for me. He's not just going to, so it may be laid out in front of me. He may be giving it to me, but it's nowhere until I grab onto it.
All right, be careful now. Don't lose your mic.
Oh,
you're getting
I'm sorry.
A little excited over
I do
there.
Get
expressing
excited.
Yourself. So, you know, that's very interesting. How many poems have you written?
I don't know. I haven't, like,
more than you
counted.
Can count, huh?
I mean, I could count it. I just haven't counted them.
Okay.
More
than 10?
Yes.
And you know, where do the words come from? Like, when you're writing, what, do you just sit there and stuff just pops in your head and you start writing?
Sometimes I write down little phrases, like, that come to me. I'll write those down. Sometimes I'll be listening to a song and I'm like, this is really, like, I'm getting a lot of emotions from this song. Or one day I was watching, like, you know, you're watching the news and with Mike Brown or something like that, I started writing, because you're so, why? Mm-hmm. You have a lot of emotion, and you, for me, the way I can express it is going to a paper and pen, or going to my laptop and trying to dig it out. Dig it out. What do I want people to know? What do I want people to hear? Because I know I'm not the only person feeling this, I just want to do this for me sometimes. Like, I just want to express this, and if y'all like it, thank you.
Now, I guess it doesn't get any better than that. Do you use technology more than, like, you know, the old-fashioned pen and paper? Like, you're on the computer, you type out your poetry, or?
I go in between. Right now, I think it's, I'm going back to, like, the paper and pen, because it's more accessible. Like, I don't always have my laptop on
me.
But I really like it. I was just writing something this week, and I'm like, okay, etch it out. It looks really messy, but I'm like, I just decided I'm going to have, like, this notebook to take with me. I tried a different, you have to find out what journal works for you too. Like, what works for you to write on?
Okay.
For me, it's just like a regular spiral.
What's your
notebook.
Favorite app for writing? Do you have one?
App?
Yeah.
Like Word?
Word, Microsoft Word is your favorite application for?
Yeah.
All right, okay. Well, you know, we certainly want to hear some of your spoken word poetry and how you're going to motivate the masses out there, because, you know, we're reaching out there. This television program is going on YouTube. You check out the YouTube pages. We love social media out there. It's a great way to get the spoken word, if you have a spoken word, to get it out there. Am I correct?
Yes.
And you're on all the social pages, I presume?
Yeah, I have a YouTube channel, and I have...
What's your name?
Poet Tentionality, so that's P-O-E-T, Poet, E-N-T, I-O-N, and then A-L-I-T-Y. So it's Poet Tentionality. I chose that because my potential for poetry reflects my personality. Please don't read too deeply into who I am. That's a discovery I live to explore.
All right, are you prepared right now to give us something?
Yes.
Go ahead, you got time.
This piece is called Life's Imprisonment. You can find it on YouTube. It's the first video I've done, and I can't wait to do more, so I hope you like it. I'm trying to escape life's imprisonment from an invisible cell with no bars or locks, but it's hard to get out. I'm only trying to succeed, but the same thing seems to impede life's trials and never easy, so I cry to the world, free me. But they look at me so demeaning, with eyes that say your place is where you're at. That's imprisonment at its best when a prisoner believes in their cell is where they're best kept. Because how do you see beyond years of confinement that has seized generations of your family in the same cell you live in, you've been in? There's no trial for this life sentence. They place you in the cell as an infant. Tell you to work hard and listen. Maybe you'll make it to the top with them. So they let you out on work release, but the work you do benefits them more than you. Striving for the American dream, but I tell you now it's the American scheme. So trying to escape life's imprisonment from an invisible cell with no bars or locks, but it's hard to get out. I'm looking out my window, but can't even chase dreams as reality reminds me that everything I see is outside the sphere of my reach, outside the realm of my belief. I guess part of my imprisonment is due to me, unable to see possibility, but the intangibles, untouchable. So living out dreams just sounds like a bunch of bull.
Wow. All right, doesn't get any better than that for my young folks. They're speaking out, and we want to hear what they got to say. We ask them all the time, and then when they say it, we don't listen. Well, we got to listen to this young lady, Miss Serena J. Walker, motivational speaker and spoken word poet. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to take a quick break right now. When we come back, I'm going to continue speaking with my great guest that we have on the panel. I especially want to give back to Chef Tony because he's a man and he's cooking, ladies, and I don't cook too well, so I got to get these tips. All right, we're going to take a quick break, and we come back to the Roof Baker and this fabulous show. I got it written down here somewhere. The Mind Matters. I should know that, but I know she's going to kill me anyway. Join us when we get back in The Mind Matters. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're back. You're listening to or you're watching The Mind Matters with Ruth Baker. Ruth Baker is taking a much-needed break right now. She asked me to come in and host the show for her, so that's what we're doing. I am Linwood Jackson. I usually host my own show every Friday, 4 to 5, on the Urban Compass with Linwood Jackson. And then we do every Sunday the Linwood Jackson radio show from 2 to 3 over at WFAI 1510. AM. So tune in. Today we're going to leave right here and shoot on over to the radio show and get that in as well. But again, we want to thank Ruth Baker for inviting us and letting us do our show. We took a break and we were listening to a song, Friends and Strangers, by Mr. Ronnie Laws. He's the younger brother of Hubert Laws. And he's one of the legendary saxophone players of all times, performing for over 50 years with the likes of the Earth, Wind, and Fire, the Crusaders. We all know the tune. He's been playing it forever on radio dials all over the place. And he's doing a show, actually, tonight over at the Waterfall. I think it's 4 o'clock. You saw the flyer. Up on the screen, there it is right there. And you can get your tickets at www.instantticket.com, instantseats.com, and or you can call the number that you see on the screen and shoot out there and check out Mr. Ronnie Laws in concert at the Waterfall Banquet right here in Claymont, Delaware. I had to give a shout out to the Witness to Innocence. People, they're doing some great work here in the Delaware state, trying to abolish the death penalty. I know there's some people with it, some people not, but I can tell you right now, here in Delaware, the majority of the people that we're executing are minorities and people of color, and we do have a high homicide rate here in our state, in our great city here in Wilmington, Delaware, as well. You know, we tell our young people all the time, stop the killing, stop the killing, stop the killing. And we, you know, it's kind of like hard to, for us as adults, to, as our young people, to stop killing. And then we turn around as adults in a society and put people on death penalty, death row. And it just boggles my mind. You know, we want to stop all the violence. All the violence. And I don't condone wrongness on either side of the fence. And that's where I'm at. So we want to give a shout out to Witness to Innocence, who are exonerating or helping a lot of people who are innocent that were formerly on death row get out of there. I think it's 200 and some odd people, whatever the number is. It's too high that they help get exonerated from death row. And so they're doing some great work over there. I want to commend them, keep them doing what they're doing. I also want to shout out to the Drifters featuring Rick Shepherd, my main man, Rick Shepherd. He's still singing, he's been singing for over 50 years as well. There's his the Christmas CD is coming out right on time for Christmas. You can order that on Amazon.com or any of your favorite record stores out there on the internet. Just Google the Drifters featuring Rick Shepherd, and it comes right up on this thing. I'd also take the lead. I do a little. I can't speak spoken word, and we try to motivate, but it is what it is. And just like young lady was saying, who gave her great spoken word speech, but. I do dance a little bit, and a lot of times I'm over here at the Celebrations on Market trying to get my dance in. And with Chef Tony, he'll tell you about that when we get him back on the mic there. And we try to inspire our Boy Scouts to get into dance too. So I want to give a shout out to my favorite dance studio, Take the Lead Dance Studio out there in Hokesson, Delaware. They're doing a great job. And I just love this. They're fantastic. You want to get into dance, any kind of dance, you want to go to Take the Lead Dance Studio and get it in. Once you learn some moves, a step or two, then you can go on out to that fine dance floor that Chef Tony has out at Celebrations on Market. I know y'all doing a lot of work that dance floor, Chef Tony.
That is correct.
We're going to get you back on here, man. because we tried to do something out there with the dance. I know you had salsa night there for a minute, and then you kind of scratched that. Didn't go too well. I suppose you did the international night, the dance. You got all kind of dancing going on out there. And tell us about the dance floor that you got there. I mean, we're going to get some. I know you had a diamond in the middle there at one time. You got rid of that.
Well, used to complain a lot about it, Linwood, and so did some of the other people because it had a ridge on it. So it was a light that was in the middle of the dance floor. So we took it out, and now the dance floor is completely level. for someone like Linwood, who needs no items to obstruct his footwork. It is a very nice dance floor. It is, and it's smooth, and whether you're bopping or cha-cha-ing or line dancing, people enjoy it. And since I removed the centerpiece that had the ridge, they like it even more, to your point.
Right, you're absolutely right. I have to agree. That's why I brought it up, you know, and I wanted to share that with the dancers out there. You know, we're getting better. Of course, we can always do better, and that's what we strive to do, and that's better. And Tony did a lot of work with the dance floor, so I got to, you know, I wasn't complaining, Tony. I would just, you know, constructive criticism or whatever, you know what I mean? I'll give my input. And obviously, you took that advice, and so I appreciate that, and that's why I want to. And now, back to this cooking, man. You know, I'm hard in the kitchen. I don't do too well in the kitchen. You got any tips for, like, young guys like myself, and I know the Boy Scouts are listening as well, for how we can do a better job in the kitchen? What's your favorite tool to work with?
My knife.
Your knife?
My chef's knife.
Your chef knife.
Yeah. Without that, you don't have anything.
Oh, okay.
You can do a lot with the chef's knife.
All right. I'm getting scared already.
But as far as, you know, tips on cooking, what are you asking? Day-to-day cooking? How can you cook better at home? What's your point of reference?
How can you cook better at home?
Good product. Starts with good product. Good vegetables, good proteins. If you start out with good product, then you end up with a tasty product. If you use bad product, you're gonna end up with something that doesn't taste good. Even when I'm working in the kitchen, a lot of my dishes are very, very simple. My favorite way of cooking is a French style of cooking, and many people think it's complicated. For me, it's not complicated because I do it all the time. But a menu is a fusion of French, Afro, Caribbean, American cuisine, and anything else eclectic that I want to cook. Like right now we have North African lamb chops, lamb shanks on the menu, and that's served with chickpeas. Very, very good. One of our most popular dishes right now is salmon. It's a Creole-style salmon, and it's just blackened salmon, and that's served with a sweet potato and bacon hash, and that's garnished with a blackstrap molasses and bourbon drizzle. Very simple. Easy, you could prepare it at home in about 30 minutes.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, that sounds like a crock pot meal. Do you don't, I guess that's
well, the
bad
the,
words for a chef.
The lamb shanks you could actually do in a crock pot.
Okay.
You would just buy your shanks, choose your favorite recipe, set the crock pot. When you come back home, you've got a great meal. Similar to if you're cooking oxtails and you put them on, or some people use a pressure, but you can cook those in a crock pot. Mm-hmm. Or you can go really old school, and my mom used to cook neck bones in a crock pot. Mm-hmm. And y'all know what they are. Mm-hmm. We've all had neck bones.
Yeah, back in the day.
And I still enjoy them.
Your go-to meal?
My go-to meal for anybody that can feel comfortable: fried fish with curried steamed cabbage and a curry ginger cream sauce.
All right. Now, Desiree, you know, for the Boy Scouts, you think the young boys out there, they cook in the Boy Scouts, don't they?
They do, actually.
They go camping?
They do. They go camping, and they're prepared to carry their gas stoves with them and prepare whatever necessary meals that's planned for that particular field trip.
All right, now, and if I, you know, want, you know, I don't do too much camping anymore, but I'm interested in working with the Boy Scouts. To be a Boy Scout leader, for me, do I need to know these type of things, I presume?
Well, it would help you if you did. However, if you didn't and you were ignorant to these kinds of things, you can absolutely evolve and learn particular things.
You know, and I got the funny feeling, I bet these young Boy Scouts will teach me.
They would teach you.
You know, you want to learn something, go to the kids. They already know half the stuff. And, you know, the teacher becomes the student. The student mm-hmm. becomes the teacher.
Absolutely.
And we each one. We learn from each other.
Sure.
And so, again, if you guys want to become a volunteer or give donations, you can certainly contact Desiree, who is an outreach coordinator for the...
I'm the outreach director for the Delmarva Council within the Boy Scouts of America.
And you guys have a contact page?
We do. You can go onto our Facebook account, which is the delmarva.org Facebook account. You can reach out to me directly at 302-530-5201. And our office location is housed out of the Community Service Building, which is 100 West 10th Street, Suite 915.
All right, now, you got it, ladies and gentlemen. Get out and get involved. You know, stop complaining about it. Be about it. And join these fine groups and organizations out there. There's plenty of them out there. We talk about the good things that's going on in our great city of Wilmington. You know, there, a lot of people talk about the bad stuff, and certainly we need to shine a light on those as well. But there's some great things going on, and we're going to put a big light on that, and that's what we're doing today. I got to thank my guests, but we still got plenty of time, and I want to take a quick break. We have a surprise guest in the studio right now, so we want to bring her on here, and so we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we're going to talk to our surprise guest. Thank you for joining us here on the Mind Matters with Ms. Ruth Baker. Ms. Ruth Baker is the president of LAPA, and they're doing great work over here at Comcast Channel 28 with the LAPA people, the LAPA organization. You know, they're running this station, and it's probably one of less than 1% of all minority-run television stations in the whole country, and LAPA is running one of them here at Comcast Channel 28. So I want to thank you for joining us and supporting us over here, and I want to thank Ruth Baker for having us on the show today. Our surprise guest is in the studio. She's working down there, but we're getting ready to put the camera on you. I got to thank, you know, Alfie Moss is in the studio. She's a fabulous songstress. She's performing all over the Delaware, the tri-state area, and the country. She's performed with presidents, and she's just out there everywhere. I'm going to bring her in here, and I don't want to take up too much time. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Alfie Moss from Alfie Moss and the Dexter Kuntz Project. Alfie.
Hi.
Did I get all of that? I know it's a whole lot more, but you can share. We want to get you in because you got a lot of things going on out in the community, and we want you to share with us. I know one thing coming up is Mr. Kim Waters.
Yes, Mr. Kim Waters, jazz great, is performing at one of our jazz vespers. We usually give one or two a year, Easter and Christmas. So this fifth annual Christmas jazz liturgy will be happening on December 19th at around 7 o'clock. And guess where it's right at? Eastside Rising Central Baptist Church on 9th and Pine Street.
All right, now I know you didn't bring Dexter with you this time, but you are part of a team. Mm-hmm. And I know you came right over from church. You're doing, yes, a lot of work with your church. You're a choir director.
I'm the choir director, and Dexter's the musical director. Mm-hmm. And thank God for you and I meeting last night. And that's why I'm here today. I thought I rearranged my schedule.
And I appreciate that because I know your time is very valuable. You're doing so much. Tell us some of the work you're doing with the boys. We talked last night. Last summer, you had the boys on bikes, they're riding around here. We have a director of the Boy Scouts here. Mm-hmm. Chef Tony's working with the kids as well. And you have a beautiful young lady sitting next to you. Just beautiful. Gave us a spoken word, by the way. And so tell us some of the work you're doing with the kids.
Well, actually, we're working as a community to bring the community up on the east side of Wilmington, Delaware. And it is it has come from like the east side blueprint, but our projects are now east side rising. And my church is very much a part of it, Central Baptist with Reverend Dr. Terrence Keeling. We've catapulted into home owners. Projects. We got projects for education that involves children. And then we have an employment agency in the bottom of our church where we take people who have had recidivism or, ex-offenders, people who cannot find work, and give them a six-week program to get them into jobs working. Some people are even working in banks. We've employed at least 80-something people, working along with 40 different partners throughout the state. So as a part of a big statewide grant for $18 million, we've been, allotted like maybe $1 million or so, and we're building new gardens, we're refurbishing homeowners' houses through Home for Habitat. And so it's a lot going on. Now, as far as the students are concerned, I'm working with Pritchett and Associates as a substitute teacher. So I'm working on, I used to work with the children in the community. Now I've graduated to the schools. Mm-hmm. And so I'm working along with Pritchett and Associates in the different schools like Family Foundation, Met School, Academia, Delaware College Prep School, a lot of schools that are needing more and more of us in those schools for those children. That's why we're so glad you're here.
Absolutely, absolutely. I commend your efforts, and I don't know how you find time to do all that. You must have an army of soldiers working with you and Dexter.
Now, speaking of that, I used to be in the Air Force.
No, you.
So I have a regiment. Wake up every morning and, thank your maker and just go for the purpose that you're here for.
The Air Force?
Yes.
Get out of here. You learn something new all the time. Alfie Moss, you're doing everything. But you're a fabulous songstress.
Yes.
Tell us about the type of music. How would you describe the
music? Our music has been, we've been voted the best jazz band in the state of Delaware. I've been voted the best jazz vocalist some years ago. Mm-hmm. But now we're working with message music and more of a pop sound. You can dance to our music now. We just mix a little bit, and we've just got through performing at Nomads with the great, great Tony Williams. And we also have been performing at Ubon's. We perform at Galuccio's. Sometimes we are down at Just in Time in the Rehoboth Beach area. Sydney Arts of Sydney Side Street is now the director over at the theater down in Dover. Mm-hmm. I forget the name of the theater. But anyway, we're performing along with her sometimes. So wherever you have a party or an event, we can now downsize the band mm-hmm. to maybe three people mm-hmm. and perform for you. So we've been doing private parties and events. So it's the Schwartz Theater down in Dover, Delaware. That's
downsize the band.
Yes.
Down to three people or yeah. as many as. How big is your band?
My band is about five pieces.
Okay. So and you're performing all over the place, but you just described how we can get in touch with you if we want to book you.
Yes.
You have a website.
I do not have a website anymore. I go with Facebook now.
That's
because
where
everybody it's simplified with Facebook mm-hmm. and it's less expensive. I can use that money to, do other things.
Gotcha. Now, mm-hmm. do you have any CDs out?
I do. I have a CD on CDBaby.com. It's called New Beginnings. Mm-hmm. And we've sold about 7,000 copies in the Delaware Valley alone.
Wow, and you can purchase it on CD Baby.
CDBaby.com or come to one of our live performances, which I advertise a lot on Facebook, so you can check that out.
All right now, and that's Alfie Moss on Facebook.
Right, Facebook/Alfie Moss. Oh. Now, we will be in performance this on the 19th should we show this now or you, not?
Yeah, get it out.
Okay.
We got 3 minutes.
Can you show that one? Dr. Reverend Keeling has a great idea about jazz becoming a part of the scripture and, you know, bringing people into the church that ordinarily would not come. Mm-hmm. So we're inviting Kim Waters this year. We also invited Gerald Veasley the year before and others. But next year we hope to invite Ronnie Laws.
Are you kidding?
We can contact him at
really?
All.
Really? You have his contact information?
I will. No, I don't.
Okay, we'll make sure we get that to you. Ronnie Laws, again, ladies and gentlemen, he is performing at the Waterfall tonight at 4 o'clock. You want to get your tickets if you haven't already. They're serving food. You get a dinner at 4, and then the show starts at 5. I believe we're going to show the flyer again. And we listen to his music, Friends and Strangers. We open the show with it. And everybody knows Ronnie Laws. Alfie Moss just talked about Mr. Kim Waters, another great saxophone player. I'm telling you, we got some great things going in the Delaware Valley and our great city of Wilmington out there. But we need you guys to participate and get out there and enjoy some of the things that's going on and help some people if you can. I want to thank our guest today, Ms. Desiree Scott-McCray with Boy Scouts of America. You got her website. She's the outreach director there, and she just said we need all the help we can get, donations and volunteers to come on out. I want to thank Chef Tony, my favorite celebrity chef, for coming on and giving us all of these great tips on how to prepare some great meals with a little bit of time and going out to the club because they got a lot of great things going on out there. I want to thank Miss Serena Walker, spoken word and motivational speaker who dramatized and very passionate about getting the word out to you. But you got to get out there and, you know, purchase these books and CDs and these clubs and just you got to get involved. You can't just sit on the couch eating your potato chips and pretzels and stuff and all this great food that Chef Tony's telling you about. You got to put that down. Get on the phone and make some calls to your politicians, anybody. There's all kinds of work and that you can get involved in to help us. All right, we need all the help we can get. Alfie Moss of Alfie Moss and the Dexter Cooch Project. All right, she's all over the place, you know, and you can get on Facebook and see what she's got coming up and what they're doing. I'm getting the finger. She got one more thing to say with Alfie
Moss. The tickets are only $35. You can get them at Morgan's of Pennsylvania Avenue, Eventbrite, Central Baptist Church Eventbrite. And, of course, you can get them at Central Baptist Church the night of the event, Saturday night, the 19th. And thank you so much for coming.
All right. Doesn't get any better than that. And I want to thank again Ms. Ruth Baker, who was the president of the LAPA, and for doing a great job with LAPA, you know, overall. And then, of course, for inviting myself to host these fabulous guests that we had on the show today. Mind matters. All right. And you know, I'm Linwood Jackson again, and we are committed to giving good inspiration and inspiring content, good content for you to use every time we're on the air. Tune in to the Urban Compass with Linwood Jackson every Friday 4 to 5 right here on LAPA and the Linwood Jackson Radio Show on WFAI 1510 AM. All right, you can get on the website, check that out too, live, both of those shows, and we need all the help we can get. So tune in, and I'll be glad to do this again if Ruth Baker will allow me to. Thank you very much, and tune in next week.